Hi, I'm Eric Farkas, Technical Marketing Manager for Black Box Network Services, and this is our customer demonstration room. Today, I'd like to talk to you about KVM trays. For those of you who don't know, KVM stands for Keyboard, Video, Mouse, and a tray is an easy way to put a keyboard, video, and mouse in a rack or cabinet in your data center to control multiple servers or other appliances that require keyboard, mouse, and monitor interaction. Today, we're going to talk about our KVT517 series. This is a full-featured KVM tray series, starting with the front panel LED. Most data centers are relatively dark. We're under a lot of lighting here for the video today, but typically this would be difficult to locate in your rack of blinking LEDs. So we give you a front panel LED, makes it easy to find, easy to grab hold, easy to pull out. This particular tray will mount into any cabinet that's 23.7 to 45.3 inches deep. The rear rails are also reversible to mount into two post racks of 3-inch or 6-inch channel. This takes up one rack unit, or 1.75 inches, within your rack, and that includes the keyboard and glide point portion of the tray, the monitor portion of the tray, and also the integrated KVM switch here in the rear. I'm going to go ahead and open this up and show you the cable management features. You can see here in the back a cable management arm. This keeps your cables within that 1U of space so they're not accidentally damaged by a server or other thing that you might slide in and out up, you know, above or below this. This features a 17-inch monitor. We have both a standard and a widescreen version available. Offers front panel switching controls. I'm just going to go ahead and select through a few ports here to show you the switching controls. Nice easy switching, short key press for ports 1 through 8, long key press for 9 through 16. As we mentioned before, this is called a dual rail design. That means that there's two rails in the one rack unit of space, and that allows us to slide the monitor out independently of the keyboard and mouse. Keyboard and mouse features, we use a notebook style keyboard with a number pad, and we also use a glide point. Both of these are field replaceable if they ever get damaged or stop working. Few screws through the bottom that you remove, mini USB connectors for both of these to connect into the tray. You can easily order a replacement part or get it fixed fast and easy. Some trays on the market don't offer that kind of functionality. We also have these little hideaways here in the back. What these are for are wireless keyboards and mice. You can hide your little transmitter here. There's a USB port on the inside. Plug in your transmitter, go ahead and replace the top cover. This is great for applications where you're monitoring. Say that you have the keyboard and mouse always retracted. You have the screen set up nice and flat here, the door closed. And you, as you can see here, you'll always be able to see what's going on in this cabinet. You can even set the switch into scan mode. It'll go through port by port, be able to tell you what's going on. A lot of customers have asked us, well, what do we do if we actually need to control this? You know, we've got a pressurized cabinet, we're forcing cold air in, we've spent all this money on infrastructure. We don't ever want to have to open this cabinet door. That little hideaway that I showed you that's hiding the wireless keyboard and mouse transmitter here, I've got my wireless keyboard that's paired up with that. You can see I hit the start button. I can go ahead and select programs or run my dashboard or make changes. I just put this away or move on to the next cabinet. Last thing I'm going to show you about the tray today is the front panel USB. Underneath the keyboard and mouse tray, there is a front panel USB connector. This is another solution for crash cart type access. If you have a keyboard or glide point go bad in your tray, and you have to order a replacement keyboard, you don't want to be down for a few days, you can walk right up, plug in a keyboard and mouse here. Inside this little hideaway, there's a few sets of dip switches, and those control how this tray interacts. It'll determine whether you've got a keyboard plugged in here, a mouse plugged in here. Also controls the glide point functionality. Important things for the data center to remember are vertical scroll, you can enable or disable, and also tapping to click, you can enable or disable, depending on your preference. So that's it for the features of our new KVM tray. Again, this is our ServView 5 series. If you have further technical questions, please contact our tech support division at 724-746-5500. Thanks for watching.